Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
This is Dario Danini, and he is with Stefano Ricci, our third of a group of suave gentlemen going to show us some tips on how to tie a tie.
The musketeer,
good one. So Dario, do you have some interesting tips on how you'd like to discuss tying a tie or show us?
Interesting tips, it's many. It depends how you wake up in the morning, first of all, and by the tie that you wear, because you can wear every single tie you want, but if it's not a good tie, or it can be a different one, it's not going to do anything. My one is very simple. And it's actually, I think it's just one wrap
around?
Oh,
why is this doing that? Okay. So what's interesting is that you're the first gentleman that says how you're tying the tie is dependent on the actual tie.
Of course.
So you mean like...
Based on the quality of it.
Oh, the quality of it. We're not talking about if it's a knit tie or a silk tie or a casual...
The quality is making the difference. So that is in life and details as well. We're fortunate enough to wear a Stefano Ricci tie and I'm not looking at it, but usually coming out extremely well.
Yes, I should tell our viewers that when you're wearing the best of the best, it helps in making a beautiful tie, right?
Well, it's not up to us to say, but our clients, that's what they're saying usually.
Yes. Okay, so now I'm noticing that after you've made your knot, then you go in and make that little dimple. Yes? The little dimple. Like, see how you used your index finger? Yes.
This is how you do it.
Okay. So you've been doing this so long you don't even need to look at a mirror. But when you first...
I don't know if it's fine.
No, it's good. It's good. So, but when you first started tying a tie, did you need to look in the mirror?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay.
Absolutely, yes.
So basically we're going to say that practice makes perfect.
Even if some morning no one's want to look yourself in the mirror. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Well, grazie mille. Thank you so much. Okay.